Hi guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, this is the second video in the series IoT with Raspberry Pi, and that's using Java. The series is divided into sensor interfacing with Raspberry Pi by using Pi4J, REST API usage with Java, MQTT usage with Java, and finally adding all to the same project and running over Raspberry Pi. In the last video, we saw how to interface DS18B20 OneWare temperature sensor with Raspberry Pi that is using Java. So if you have not checked that, you can certainly check that out by clicking the link down below given in the description. So this video is the second in the series. We'll see how to publish or send sensor data using REST API to cloud. And in this, we are using ThingSpeak as the cloud service provider to publish our data. HTTP calls for REST API is done using UniREST lightweight HTTP client library. And in the next video, we'll see how to do the same by using MQTT. And we'll try to send the same data to the same service provider, that is ThingSpeak, but over MQTT interface. So being said that, let's get started, guys. So guys, as I said earlier, we are going to publish our temperature data to ThingSpeak. And to do that, we need to create one channel on ThingSpeak where we can publish our data. And for with that channel will be having one field, that will be the temperature only. So to do that, let's open up thingspeak.com. If you don't have any account over here, you just need to create or sign up for a new account. Otherwise, you can simply log in with your credentials. And over here, I'm using ThingSpeak. But if you are already using any other services, you can go ahead with that. But you just need to have the REST API for the particular service. So coming to ThingSpeak, over here, get on channels, my channel, and let's create a simple channel having one field only. Now let's give it a name. Let's say WG. You can give it any name you want, and I'll have only one temp data, that is temperature. So you can provide metadata tag if you want. You can make it public, so location, all those things. Okay, I'll what is this. Now click on save channel, and over here we need to just copy few things to work with this. And I'll just copy the name, the channel ID, the parameter we provided, that is temperature, that is not required. I just need few more things. Those are API keys, and as we are going to publish only, so we'll just need the right API key. Just copy this one. Now let's check out how to do REST calls to ThingSpeak to update channel or send data. And I'll just get into documentation, channel charts API, and get into REST API. And over here, you'll see something like updated channel feed. Now, this allows us to send data over like REST API, and for that, you can use text as data, you can use JSON, otherwise, you can use XML. But for this tutorial, I'm going to use JSON only. So let's copy these things over here, and I'll just copy the response to cross validate. So we have set up our ThingSpeak. So let's get into Eclipse IDE, and we'll try to write a simple program that can send temperature data to this particular channel over here. And later on, we'll see the data that has been received by this ThingSpeak channel over here from our Java client from our Raspberry Pi. So we'll have visualizations for that. It will show you in graphs and all. So we'll check that out later on. So let's open up Eclipse. And I'll just continue with the app that we created last time in the first part, that where we interfaced with the sensor that is in hardware class. So if you have not checked that, you can certainly check that out, for which I have given the link down below in the description. So let's create another class that can be used to call the REST API of ThingSpeak. And to use the API, and for the HTTP communication or the REST API, etc., we are going to use one library, that is UniREST. So we first need to download the required library, that is UniREST. So you can just simply Google it, and actually I have given the download link. So just Google UniREST jar, and it will give you jar download file. Otherwise, if you are using Maven already, you can certainly add the dependency. But as I am not using Maven right now, I'll just get with jardownload.com, which will provide me a link with all dependencies that is required by UniREST. So coming on to UniREST, it is a simple lightweight HTTP client library that is developed over Apache HTTP client and other supported libraries. Okay, it says it is over here saying there is a new version, so click on it. Now over here, just click on download UniREST Java jar version, and it comes with all the dependencies those are required for it. So you don't need to install the dependencies independently. Now after the download completes and you extracted the zip file, will get the UniREST jar file along with the dependencies, that is commons codec, then logging, HTTP async client, HTTP client, HTTP core, and all those things along with JSON and all. So we just need to add these jar files to our project, and to do that I can simply navigate to build path, configure build path, get into add external jars. So once again, if you are new to like Java application development for Raspberry Pi, you can check out my earlier tutorial on this, and select the libraries that you want to add. Click on OK, open, sorry, hit on OK. Now after adding the jar files, we'll see those files under reference libraries. So let's close it. Now let's create one class that will be used to send our data to ThingSpeak over REST API. And to do that, simply click on the project, create new class, and this will be like something REST call, and I'll use the package that is and over here I'll create one method that is public, and it will take one parameter for time being, that is the temperature. So you can just simply modify this code to suit your requirement. Over here I have just considered one sensor, that is temperature sensor only, but you can change it. Now I just need to copy the code over here, and I have just given the link down below in the description for the GitHub repository for this. So just copy this code. So as we are having async call, I'll just get it to void, and over here in the code, just you need to change few parameters over here to suit your channel requirement. So now this is the UniREST post statement that looks something like this, which is like UniREST.post, and it contains the URL where you want to send your data using HTTP post. And over here you just need to add the API URL that is we got from ThingSpeak. So just paste it over here, but as it is already having that, I'm not going to change it. You just need to change the API key, and that is of your application, and for me it is something like then. As we have already added only one field, this will be field one only, and I will add temperature over here. Now it has something like add JSON async, means this is a synchronous call, so whenever the call completes or it fails, it is going to call back interface, and that is different methods like failed, completed or cancelled. So if the call fails, it will simply print out system.out like the request has failed. If the request is cancelled, it will print out the request has been cancelled. Otherwise, if it is like the request is successful, it will print out like the code, the HTTP code that has received like 200 or 405 or anything, that depends upon the state. Then it will print out the body and the raw body, and after that we'll just shut down the unirest. So to use this function, let's get into the main function, and which we actually created earlier. I'm just going to comment out these things for time being. I'll create new object for rest call. I just can use this http dot send data over rest, and I can use any value. Let's say for time being I'll use 45. Now let's run it once, and after like running successfully, it will print out the result of it. And if it has print out 200, that means it has successfully communicated, and along with it will print out the JSON returned by the thingspeak.com. So let's check on thingspeak.com if we have successfully sent our data. And to do that, get into your private view, and you will see something like temperature, and that is 45, and we'll have one entries as you have sent only once, and it is showing the data that we sent, that is nothing but 45 over here. So in this way, you can simply send your data to ThingSpeak or whatever website that supports REST API. And for this tutorial, I have used Unirest as a library to have the HTTP calls and all. But if you are using any other library, that's okay. Just you need to support JSON and the HTTP POST or GET, depending upon whatever you are using. Now let's create the runnable jar file, and we'll take it to Raspberry Pi, and we'll test it there if it works. To do that, I'll simply create one executable jar file. Click on runnable jar file. Just have anything over here. Again, if you are new to this, you can check out my earlier tutorial on this. Now let's open up WinSCP. Copy the test.jar and test_leaf folder. Open up putty. Now let's try to run the jar file. To do that, I'll simply use the command sudo java jar desktop then test.jar, and let's see if we are getting our data on ThingSpeak. Okay, it is saying request is failed as it is not having internet connection over here. So to do that, I'll just need to change my IP settings and all. So just let me do that, and we'll try to run it once again. So now that we are having internet connection, let's run the file once again. Let's see if we are able to successfully send the data. Yep. And you can see over here, it has responded with the response, and that is 200 means it has successfully communicated. And we'll find something like field 1 equals 45, that is the data we sent to the server. So let's check on ThingSpeak and see if we have received the data. So let's navigate to ThingSpeak, and you can see over here it is again showing 45 over here, and that is with the current timestamp and the current time. That means we are able to send our data from Raspberry Pi using REST API to ThingSpeak. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching. And this is the second video in the series, that is IoT with Raspberry Pi. And I will be coming with other videos pretty soon. So stay tuned for that. And I hope you have liked this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, consider subscribing it for latest videos and updates. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.